It's rise and shine time. We've just been in here warming our voices up, and we didn't plan this out. Charlie Beck was supposed to be here this morning, but there was some massive dispute with his hospitality rider. He wanted live goats. We only had goat stew, something like that.
It happens every time with Charlie.
Yeah, I mean, you thought brown M&Ms was bad, but this guy, tell you what. So I'm T Claw. I'm the new music and dance events coordinator at the Folk School, and I'm
Gabe. I'm the Wood Studios coordinator.
So we just decided last night we would fill in for Charlie. You'll get to meet him soon, I'm sure. But another thing we decided was that we didn't really need to decide on any kind of set list, so this is going to be organic. I decided to put this fiddle in a tuning that I haven't played in for about 10 years. So it's called Calico Tuning, and it's tuned to an open G chord, kind of like the banjo. Because I remembered that there's this tune I wanted to play and that it also fits in this tuning. It's called Hunting the Buffalo. I am not sure where this tune comes from. So please fill me in if you know. Should we start with that and then figure out what song to do?
Yes, sir.
Alrighty.
Sing this. There's a call and response called Bright Morning Stars. You might know this song. So I'll sing, and then there's a response that's the line I just sang, and then I'll sing another line, and then there's the response, Day is Breaking in My Soul. So you'll sing that.
Cheery one.
Yeah, it is. This is a cheery one. Okay. Bright morning stars are rising. Bright morning stars are rising. Day is a breaking in my soul.
So that's your part. Day is breaking in my soul.
Yeah. And where are our dear fathers? Oh, where are our dear fathers? They're down in the valley a praying. Heaven a shouting, day is a breaking in my soul. And how can I be lonely, my Lord is ever near. Surrounds me. Day is a breaking in my soul. Bright morning stars are shining. Bright morning stars are shining. Morning stars are shining. Day is a breaking in my soul. Thank you. Good job.
Thanks for singing along. I'm going to put this back in another tuning, I suppose, while we figure out what we're playing next. How was, for those of you who are here, how was your week at the folk school? Yeah. Top choice? Best ever?
Yes. Good to hear. I took a class this week at the folk school. I took a, Jane Rothfield's fiddle class, and it was great. It was so nice playing fiddle all week and hanging out with other students. That's not to say I'm going to play the fiddle today. My arm's too tired.
All right. Should we play Lost Indian?
Okay.
This one should wake us up.
Thank you.
let's talk about where we're sitting today, where we're being and working. So that tune was called Lost Indian, and I know there's a lot of lost Native Americans that have, you know, given their land for us to be here, and also the Scroggs family after that, you know. So I just want to give thanks to the Cherokee, Eastern Band of Cherokee, for whose land this was, and appreciate what they gave and what where we are. You know, this is a beautiful place to be. I just moved here a couple months ago, and I'm really appreciating the natural area and the rivers, and yeah. So just a little notion for the day to give thanks for the place we occupy.
Yeah, and I say for myself too, T-Claw, that, yeah, working here every day, I try to acknowledge that Brasstown Valley itself was a really important place for the Cherokee people, and they had been homesteading here, and the place where we work and live every day was the beginning of what's called the Trail of Tears, and this is where folks left off from when they left their homes in North Carolina to go to Oklahoma. So just try to remember that every day.
Yeah, I wonder if I know Benton Flippin played that tune, but I, you know, there were Native fiddlers who probably influenced that sound, or maybe even wrote that tune. A lot of these old traditional tunes, you don't really know exactly where they came from, because it was before recordings, before people wrote this stuff down. So
yeah, around here, especially in western North Carolina, far western North Carolina, there were lots of Cherokee fiddlers, and they made a big impact on old time music that we play today.
Well, should we move back to my homeland and try that Delmore Brothers song?
Okay. Do you want me to play guitar? Or what do you want to do?
Could I play guitar?
Yeah.
So I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, home of the Grand Ole Opry, Music City, USA. But this song is a very early kind of...
Is this the one you played last night?
Yeah. Gabe's heard it once before.
I heard it once. I will mumble the harmony lyrics because I don't know them great.
Yeah, so the core, so this is the Delmore Brothers. I think they released this in 1935. Very early country music around the Grand Ole Opry. And it's a sad kind of cowboy song. I don't think they were cowboys. They were from Alabama. That was kind of what was in the 30s, I think, the Western ballady stuff. So, do you have a capo somewhere?
Yeah.
I think D might be a little better. Thank you. Tell you the chorus. Let me look at it real quick. I'm riding along out on the lone prairie. The rangers are searching for me. I'm riding away from my home in Texas, a fugitive ever to be. So if you want to sing, I'll say that one more time. So say it after me. I'm riding along. Out on the lone prairie.
Out on the lone prairie.
The rangers are searching for me.
The rangers are searching for me. I'm riding away from my home in Texas.
A fugitive ever to be.
A fugitive ever to be.
So I'll start with a verse. And I hear the sad howling of coyotes prowling. They sound so mournful to me. It brings back memories of cherished loved ones, the ones I'm longing to see. I'm riding along out on the lone prairie. The rangers are searching for me. I'm riding away from my home in Texas, a fugitive ever to be.
T-Claw and I both spent some time in the Pacific Northwest, and there's a mountain range there called the Cascades. If you want to go in the mountains, that's where you go. And so I wrote this ballad about a couple of friends of ours who would go up there and go fishing. And so this is a song about the old Snoqualmie Trail. The Snoqualmie River flows from the Cascades down into the Seattle area, big wilderness area. So the old Snoqualmie Trail. In the heat of the summer, high in the Cascades, two gents went a-ramblin' on a cold rainy day. Their names are known to some in this crowd. Fitzpatrick, Fitzpatrick, and old man McLeod. That's Johnny Fitzpatrick.
Yeah, I see.
They fished their way up the old Snoqualmie. Said one to the next, buddy, how can this be? No fish on our lines, but tons in the brook. They don't favor the flies we've tied on our hooks. Fitzpatrick, Fitzpatrick, and old man McLeod made camp in high country where the morels are found. A log cabin fire to keep out the chill, tobacco and whiskey till they had their fill. The North Star appeared and they laid out their beds. McLeod's eyes grew wide and softly he said, it seems there's a thing I've forgotten to pack, my trusty old bedroll and wool sleeping sack. Fitzpatrick then knew they were both in a bind and said to McLeod, let's just clear our minds. Let's brew some camp coffee and think of a plan. For my sleeping bag has just room for one man. Fitzpatrick stood up and dug down in his pack, while McLeod produced beans from an old tin cloth sack. Fitzpatrick sat down, I've a thing to confess. It seems I've forgotten my old AeroPress. So they crushed up their beans on hard Cascade rock and squeezed out their brew through an old woolen sock. Both men poured a mug and tried not to taste, then climbed into bed and lay face to face.
Oh, that's great. I never heard that. I know these guys that he was singing about, so it's even better for me.
Yeah.
Sock brew.
That's not a good way to do it.
It's the new thing. It's
yeah, it's artisan.
You throw an egg in
it. Oh god. What are you gonna do?
Policeman?
Okay.
Can we do that? I think we have time for one more or so before breakfast. This is one of the first tunes I heard. So I was a punk rocker, and one of the first tunes I heard on a banjo was this song, and I was sold. I'm very much into Biscuits, and this song has Biscuits in it, and I think it's a good theme for getting us all to breakfast. But